Hi, we are from At Home Tuition. In this video, we are going to see two examples on how to estimate the square root of the given number. The first example is, a gardener has 1000 plants. He wants to plant these in such way that the number of rows and the number of columns remain the same. Find the minimum number of plants he need more for this. Okay, so first we'll see what's given. Okay, so it's given number of plants gardener has equal to 1000 plants. So the condition given is plants in number of rows is equal to plants in number of columns. So what they are asked us to find, they asked us to find the minimum number of plants he needed more for this. Okay, so they have given 1000 plants. Also we want to find how many more minimum plants are needed to plant such that number of rows is equal to number of columns. Now let's consider the number of rows be x. Okay, so it's given plants in number of rows is equal to plants in number of columns. So if you have taken x number of rows, the number of columns should also be x. That's the condition. So therefore, total number of plants is equal to plants in number of rows into plants in number of columns. That's if you multiply plants in the rows into plants in the columns, you will get total number of plants. So here we have considered plants in the rows as to be x, so and plants in the columns also to be x. So total number of plants is equal to x into x. Since x into x, so the total number of plants should be a perfect square number. Okay, so now we can substitute total number of plants to be 1000 because it's given. So 1000 equal to x into x, so 1000 equal to x square. So taking square root to find x, so square root of 1000 equal to square root of x squared. So this square root and the square will get cancelled. So you'll get only x. So x is equal to square root of 1000. So to find the square root of 1000, we can use long division method. So in this long division method, first we want to write the number. Then we have to pair the digits from ones place and we have to place a bar. So I have paired 0, 0, I have placed a bar. Then I have paired 0 and 1 and I have placed a bar over here. Then we have to consider the number under the leftmost bar. So here it is 10 and we want to find the number for divisor and quotient such that they are equal and whose square is less than this dividend. So now we know that it's 3. So 3 into 3, that's 3 square is 9. So I am writing 9 here. So 10 minus 9 is 1, that's the remainder. The next step, I'm going to bring the number under the next bar down. So it will be 0, 0. The new dividend is 100. Now I'm going to double the quotient 3. So it will be 6. Now I want to write a number such that this new number into this new quotient will be less than or equal to this 100. So I have written 161 into 1, that is 61. So here, so if you go with 62 into 2, you'll get 124, which is more than 100. So it's not possible. So I'm writing 61 into 1, so which is 61. So 100 minus 61 is 39. Since the remainder is not 0 and there are no numbers left under the bar, and we can conclude that 1000 is not a perfect square number. And also the quotient is 31. And we can say that 31 square is less than 1000, because we got a remainder, we can say that 31 square is less than 1000. But it is given, we need to find the minimum number of plants he needs more for this. So we need to find minimum number to be added to 1000 to make it a perfect square. So to do this, we are going to take the next number from the quotient. So that's 32, and 32 square minus 1000 is the minimum number. So 32 square is 32 into 32, which is equal to 1024. So 1024 minus 1000 is 24. So thus the gardener needs 24 more plants to be planted such that the number of rows is equal to plants in the number of columns. The next example is, there are 500 children in a school. For a PT drill, they have to stand in such a manner that the number of rows is equal to number of columns. How many children would be left out in this arrangement? Okay, solution. So let's see what's given. So number of children in the school is 500 and the condition given is students have to stand in such a manner. Students in number of rows is equal to students in number of columns. So what you are asked to find, how many children would be left out in this arrangement? So now Same way, let's consider the number of rows to be x. Since it's given number of rows equal to number of columns, so if you consider number of rows as x, then number of columns should also be x. Okay, therefore the total number of students, we can say that students in number of rows into students in number of columns. So we can take it as x into x. Total number of students is x into x. So total number of students should be a perfect square number, so that we can take that number of rows equal to number of columns. So now we'll substitute total number of students as 500. So 500 equal to x into x, 500 equal to x squared. So now taking square root to find the value of x. So square root of 500 equal to square root of x squared. So this square root and this square will get cancelled. You will get only x. So x equal to square root of 500. So to find the square root of 500, again we are going for long division method. So in the long division method, we know that first we have to pair the digits and we have to place a bar. So here 0, 0. We are pairing from 1's place, 0, 0 is paired and place the bar. Then 5, we have to place a bar over 5. Then we have to find a number such that whose square is less than or equal to 5. So 2 into 2 is 4, which is less than 5. So 5 minus 4 is 1. Then we are bringing the number into the next bar down. So the new dividend is 100. We are doubling the quotient, this 2. So it will become 4. The new number, so suppose if you take 1, so the same 1 will become the new quotient. So 41 into 1 will be 41. So it's very much less than 100. So now I am trying with 42. So 42 into 2 is 84. So which is less than 100. So I am writing 42 here and 2 here. So and 42 into 2 is 84. So 100 minus 84 and the remainder is 16. So since the remainder is not 0, the given number 500 is not a perfect square number. So and the remainder is 16. So we can subtract this remainder, okay, from the given number to get the perfect square number. So the number of students in row and column will be equal. So if you arrange like that, then 16 students will be left out. So if you arrange all the number of students in rows and columns as equal, then 16 students will be left out of this arrangement. Hope you have understood how to find the square root, how to estimate the square root. Okay, thank you for watching the video.